ओम शांति, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे सतगुरु डे, डेट इज 20th June 2024, बाबा साकार वर्जन। दिस मॉर्निंग मुरली, ओम शांति बाप दादा मधुबन। एसेंस ऑफ टुडेज मुरली, बाबा सेट, स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, डू नॉट वेस्ट योर टाइम चेजिंग आफ्टर ए हैंडफुल ऑफ चिकपीस, मीन्स थिंग्स ऑफ लिटल वैल्यू। Now become the Father's helpers and glorify the Father's name, especially for the Kumaris, because Kumaris are sitting in front of Baba, so Baba is taking into that account. Baba is just giving that intoxication to Kumaris, especially today, and Baba is asking to see the value of these teachings of this world and the teachings, that is spiritual teachings that Baba is giving. Now, question from today's Murli: what are the signs of you moving forward on this path of knowledge? Very subtle things Baba is telling today. Baba is giving answer: the children who constantly remember the land of peace and the land of happiness, and whose intellects do not wander anywhere at the time of remembrance, those whose intellects don't have wasteful thoughts, whose intellects are concentrated, who don't nod off, and whose maturity of happiness is high, prove that they are moving forward on this path of knowledge. So we are now on the path of knowledge. Now, whether we are progressing or not, how to check it? Then some checking points Baba has given today's Murli, that especially regarding our concentration in the remembrance. Om Shanti. You children have been sitting here for so long, it enters your hearts that it is as though you are sitting in Shivalaya, means temple of Shiva. You remember Shiv Baba and you also remember heaven. Only by having remembrance do you receive happiness. Even if your intellects remember that you are sitting in Shivalaya, you will be happy. So, Baba says, consider yourself that you are sitting in this Shivalaya. Madhubani Shivalaya is where Shiva Baba is coming. Brahma Baba's chariot is also Shivalaya, in which Baba is sitting and teaching us. So, Baba says, eventually you all have to go to Shivalaya. No one is going to sit permanently in the land of peace. In fact, the land of peace is called Shivalaya and the land of happiness is also called Shivalaya. So today Baba has told this land of peace also as Shivalaya. Both are established by the Father. And this is new point today. Baba says, Baba is establishing new world, that is Shivalaya. But this supreme abode, that is also a Shivalaya Baba is establishing. How? Because the souls are peaceless now, so Baba just make them free from all the tension, all the burden, all the bondages, and Baba will they will stabilize in their old religion, peace, and then Baba will take them to home. So there they will rest in peace. So Baba says, you children have to remember both of them. That Shivalaya is for peace and the other Shivalaya is for happiness. The supreme abode is for peace and new world, that is heaven, is for happiness. This is the land of sorrow. You are now sitting at the confluence age. You must not remember anything except the land of peace and the land of happiness. No matter where you may be sitting, even if you are at your business, your intellect should remember both Shivalaya, that is Paramdham and New World. You have to forget the land of sorrow, that is Old World. You children know that this process, this land of sorrow, is now to end. You children should not nod off while sitting here. The intellects of many children wander off in other directions. There are obstacles of Maya. That's why they are wandering. The father repeatedly tells you children, children, manmana bhava. He also tells you various tactics while you are sitting here. Verses make your intellects remember that you will first go to Sivalaya, the land of peace, and that you will then go to the land of happiness. By remembering this, your sins will continue to be cut away. So today, one more method Baba is telling. Wherever you are sitting, you remember Supreme Abode, and then you remember the heaven also, your sins will be cut away. The more you stay in remembrance, the more you will move forward. You should not sit here with any other thoughts. This tactic Baba is telling today, just to go forward. We should not stick where we are. We have to progress. Baba says, otherwise you would be causing a loss for others. So you should not sit here with any other thoughts, because other thoughts will spoil the energy where Baba is there in front of us in Madhuban. Instead of benefiting them, you would be causing them a loss. So other people, they will also lose their concentration. So we will be responsible to spoil the atmosphere, environment. So previously, when you were made to sit in meditation, someone was made to sit in front of you to check who were nodding off and who were sitting with their eyes closed. Then Baba Dadi were telling that when they were in Pakistan, that is especially in Karachi, during that Bhatti 14 years. So Baba made some special group of some Kumaris and allowed them to stay in Baba's remembrance. And one another big Kumari was kept there to watch whether their eyes are closed, whether they are just their heads are straight, or just they are dozing. So sometimes that while remembering Baba, somebody went to trance also, and Baba will show the scene who is not remembering accurately as Baba wants. And then they will narrate. So they were also cautious that my name should not be there. Baba should not narrate me also in that vision. So that much efforts they made. That is what Baba is telling today. Therefore, you remained very cautious. The father also used to see whether your intellect yoga was wandering anywhere or if you were nodding off. Many come here and don't understand anything. To whom we are taking before Baba, that also we have to see. That's what Baba is telling today. Brahmin teachers bring them. Very good children should be in front of Shiv Baba so that they don't create the wrong impression, because that one is not an ordinary teacher. Shiv Baba is true and he is telling us the truth only. And Baba can say, speak anything because he is supreme teacher. So Baba says they will misunderstand and they will just do disservice outside after going from Madhuban. So then Baba wants to say that pakka students should be brought before Baba. The father sits here and teaches you. You should sit here with great caution. Baba makes you sit in silence for 15 minutes, but you sit for an hour or 2 hours. When we are going to meet Baba, in advance we are sitting there, we are making our position, we are concentrating. So some meditation practical also they are conducting. So Baba will give drashti for 15 minutes, but before 2-3 hours we have to stay there. So not everyone is a Maharathi. Those who are weak have to be cautioned. By being cautioned, they will become alert and careful. It is as though those who don't stay in remembrance but simply continue to have waste thoughts are creating obstacles because their intellects keep wandering somewhere or other. All elephant riders, horse riders and foot riders are sitting here. So Baba is categorizing. Baba has come today having churned the ocean of knowledge. So Baba everything above Baba told about our concentration in remembrance. Now Baba is talking about services. So Baba says, Baba has come today having churned the ocean of knowledge. Means Brahma Baba is telling his experience. The models of Shivalaya, the brothel and the most auspicious conference is all three that you children saw at the museum and exhibitions are a very good way to explain this knowledge to people. You should make very big ones. You should get the biggest and best halls for them so that this quickly sits in their intellects. So our museum is also there in Abu. Baba says it's a good service, but Baba is just giving some suggestions. You children should think about these things and think about how to improve them. You should make the most auspicious conference is very good. People can receive a very good understanding through that. You saw 5 to 6 people sitting in tapasya, but Baba says no. You should show 10 to 15 people sitting in tapasya. You should make very big pictures and write in very clear writings. You explain so much and yet people don't really understand. You make effort to explain, but they have stone intellects. So as much as possible, you should explain very clearly. Those who remain engaged in doing service should think about how to increase service. So Baba says you should think that how we can increase the services. There isn't as much pleasure in explaining using the projector and exhibitions as there is when explaining at museum. So the service of museum is more effective. That's what Baba says, because on the projector, when we project some pictures, it will just moving one by one by one. Whereas in the museum, they can stay before the pictures. The writings are also there. They will try to understand. If not understood, Baba's children are there to explain the picture. So that's why Baba says the service through museum is very nice. They don't understand anything through the projectors. The best of all is the museum. Even though it may be small, in one room there should be the scenes of Shivalaya, the brothel, and the most auspicious conference age. The Baba says first this brothel, then in between auspicious conference age, and then Shivalaya where we are going. So accordingly, in sequence, we have to make the models and explain them. A very broad and unlimited intellect is needed to explain this. The unlimited father and the unlimited teacher has come, but he is not just going to sit down thinking that the children should pass their MA or BA. So some Kumaris may have thoughts in their mind. So Baba says, or somebody may have said that I will complete my degree, then I will be surrendered like that. Baba says the father is not just going to remain seated here. He will leave in a short time. There is little time left and people still don't awaken. Those who are good daughters would say, why should I waste my time for just this 400 to 500 rupees? And in those days, the salary was this much only. What status would I then claim in Shivalaya? Baba says that the Kumaris are free. No matter how high a salary you receive, it is just like a handful of chickpeas. All of that is going to end. Nothing will remain. The father has now come to make you give up the handful of chickpeas. However, some don't let it go at all. There you receive a handful of chickpeas, whereas here you receive the sovereignty of the world. Those are just chickpeas worth a few pennies, so why do you distress yourself chasing after them? Kumaris are free. Baba says, Kumars, they may have some responsibility of their parents, but Kumaris are free. Those studies are only worth a few pennies. If you stop those studies and continue to study this knowledge, your intellects can open. little daughters should sit and give this knowledge to the older ones and explain that the father has come to establish Shivalaya. You know that everything here is going to turn to dust. You won't even have those chickpeas in your fortune. And if you will earn it, Baba says, it may not be in your fortune. Some might have 5 chickpeas, that is 5 lakh rupees in their hands, but that too would be destroyed. There is now very little time left. Day by day, conditions are getting worse. Suddenly, there are calamities. Death takes place suddenly. Even while holding chickpeas in their fist, they leave their bodies. So, people have to be liberated from this monkey-like behavior. The monkey like this chickpeas, that's why Baba is giving the example. Baba says, don't become happy on just seeing the museum. You have to show wonders. People have to be reformed. The father is giving you children the sovereignty of the world. However, some won't even have chickpeas in their fortune. Everything will be destroyed. So many times Baba is telling today. Instead, why not claim the sovereignty from the father? There isn't any difficulty in this. You simply have to remember the father and spin the discourse of self-realization. You have to empty your fist of chickpeas and fill them with diamonds and jewels and return home. This is what Baba wants to say today. The father explains, sweet children, why do you waste your time chasing after a handful of chickpeas? Yes, if someone is old and has many children, he has to look after them. It is very easy for Kumaris. When anyone comes, just explain to them that the father is giving us this sovereignty. So you should claim the sovereignty. Your feet are now becoming full of diamonds. Everything else is going to be destroyed. The father explains, you have been committing sin for 63 births. Another sin is of defaming the father and the deities. So two types of sins, Baba says, up till now, for 63 births, 5 vices were there due to body consciousness, and due to that we have committed sins. But another sin, Baba says, to defame our father and deities too, Baba says, that's another thing. So you became vicious and you also insulted the father. You insulted the father so much. The father sits here and explains to you children, children, do not waste your time. Do not say, Baba, I cannot stay in remembrance. Say, Baba, I am unable to remember myself as a soul. I forget myself. To become body conscious means to forget yourself. So if you are unable to remember yourself as a soul, how would you be able to remember the father unless and until we stabilize in our own introduction means own religion? We cannot remember Baba. We cannot. We are not connected. So the destination is very high. This is why this is very easy. But yes, there is also opposition from Maya. Although people study the Gita, etc., they don't understand the meaning of it at all. The main scripture of Bharat is Gita. Each religion has its own scripture. None of those who establish a religion can be called the Satguru. That is a big mistake. There is only the one Satguru, but there are many who call themselves Guru. So Tatsatta Guru means the true Guru who is showing the path of liberation and liberation in life. Now, says, if someone teaches the work of a carpenter or an engineer, he too is a Guru. Sometimes family members are also our Guru who are pointing out our weaknesses. Now, says, anyone who teaches something is a Guru. But there is just the one Satguru who have now found the Satguru. You have now found the Satguru. He is also the true father and the true teacher. This is why you children should not be careless. You live here having become very well refreshed, but you forget everything as soon as you arrive home. Now from going from Madhuban, Baba says you will forget everything. A lot of punishment is received in the jail of your womb. If we have to take a rebirth, Baba says there is punishment period. There a womb is a palace in the new world. There are no sinful acts performed. That one would have to experience punishment in the womb. Here in Madhuban, you children understand that you are personally studying with the Father. A personal study Baba is giving. So Baba says, outside at your home, you would not say the same. There you would understand that your brother is teaching you. So human beings, you all are brothers. And Supreme Teacher, Supreme Soul is our Father. He is teaching us. So you have come here directly in front of the Father. The Father explains to you children very well. There is a difference, Baba says, between the way the Father explains and the way you children explain. The Father sits here and questions you children. He says, child, child, and explain to you. That's a love. With love, he is explaining, and he is explaining to the soul, not to the body. So that is the difference. You understand Shivalaya means temple of Shiva, and the brothel means Vaishyalaya. It is a matter of the unlimited. Baba says, show this clearly so that people can enjoy it. There you explain in a light manner, but you have to explain to them seriously so that they can understand it very clearly. Have mercy for yourselves. Are you just going to stay in this brothel? And how to do the service? Baba is teaching. Baba has thoughts about how to explain. Children make so much effort, yet it is as though nothing sinks in. They continue to say, yes, yes, it is very good, and you should also explain this in the villages. Though they don't understand anything themselves. Wealthy people with a lot of money will not understand. They do not pay any attention to this at all. They will come at the end, but it will then be too late. Neither will their wealth be useful, nor will they be able to stay in yoga. Because the disturbance will be there in the world. However, yes, Baba says, if they listen to this, they will become part of the subjects. The poor can claim a very high status. What do you Kumaris have? And Baba says, you are also poor. Means the Kumaris say to be poor because it is the sons who receive their father's inheritance. And in those days, now the law has changed from 2005. Baba says, but yes, after a Kumari is given away, she indulges in vice. They say, get married and I will then give you money. If you want to remain pure, you won't get a single penny. Look at that attitude, Baba ji. How parents are there. You must not be afraid of anyone. You should explain everything openly. You should be very active. You are telling the complete truth. This is the confluence age. On that side is a handful of chickpeas and on this side is a handful of diamonds. From being like a monkey, you are now becoming worthy of becoming in a temple. So you should make effort and claim a birth like a diamond. Your faces should be like that of a courageous goats. They would be afraid of even a little sound. The Father questions all of you children. Kumaris should not become trapped. If you become trapped in bondages, you will be beaten for vice. If you imbibe this knowledge well, you will become empresses of the world. The Father says, I have come to give you the sovereignty of the world. However, this is not in the fortune of some. The father is the lord of the poor. Kumaris are poor. When parents are unable to get their daughters married, they give her away. So Kumaris should be very intoxicated. I should study well and claim a good status. Good students pay attention to their studies so that they pass with honors. They are the ones who then receive a scholarship. The more effort you make, the higher the status you will receive, and that too will be for 21 births. So here there is temporary happiness in this world. Today you receive a status, but if you die, the next day everything is finished. So there is difference between yogis and bogis. The difference of this world and this confluence is study, Baba is telling today. Those who indulge in sensual pleasure, means, that is the difference. The father says, pay greater attention to the poor. Scarcely any wealthy ones take this up. They simply say, this is very good. This organization is very good and it will benefit many people, but they don't benefit themselves at all. They say that this is very good, but as soon as they go outside, everything is over. Maya is sitting with a stick and makes them lose all enthusiasm. By slapping them just once, she makes them lose all their wisdom. The father explains, look what the condition of Bharat has become. You children have understood the drama very well. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap, Dada. The spiritual father says, namaste to the spiritual children, and we spiritual children with love say namaste to the स्पिरिचुअल फादर. मीठे मीठे सिकी लदे बच्चों प्रति मात पिता बाप दादा का याद प्यार और गुड मॉर्निंग रूहानी बाप की रूहानी बच्चों को नमस्ते. हम रूहानी बच्चों की रूहानी मात पिता बाप दादा को याद प्यार गुड मॉर्निंग और नमस्ते. थैंक यू वेरी मच बाबा. सो एसेंस फॉर धारणा फ्रॉम टूडेज मुरली पॉइंट नंबर वन. लेट गो ऑफ handful of chickpeas and make full efforts to claim the sovereignty of the world from the father. Do not be afraid of anything. Third, become fearless and remain free from bondages. Use your time in worthwhile way in earning a true income. So four things in first point. Second, forget this land of sorrow and remember Shivalaya. That is the land of peace and the land of happiness. Both are Shivalaya. Recognize the obstacles of Maya and remain cautious of them. So the land of peace is, Baba says, it's a home of our father, the ocean of peace. But Baba taking all souls in peaceful stage. That's why Baba says he is establishing that land also. So blessing for today, may you become a conqueror of attachment and an embodiment of remembrance by studying and teaching the lesson of the Gita. Baba explains, the first lesson of the knowledge of the Gita is become a bodiless soul. That is first lesson. The final lesson is become a conqueror of attachment and an embodiment of remembrance. So the first lesson is the method and the final lesson is the result of the method. So first of all, study these lessons yourself at every moment and then teach them to others. Perform such elevated actions that on seeing you perform elevated actions, all souls will perform elevated action and be able to make their lines of fortune elevated. So that service we have to do. Slogan from for today, stay merged in God's love and you will be liberated from having to work hard. Om Shanti. So we will remember Baba for a minute.